Hello everyone, I'm Vero, and in this video I'm going to share with you my opinion about the new graphic tablet that Veikk has launched, the Voila L. When people at Veikk asked me if I was interested in reviewing this pen tablet, I said yes because it has a very interesting feature. Mechanical keys, oh my god. I love when tablets, graphic tablets, have keys on them because I like to set shortcuts that I can reach with the hand I'm drawing with, because I usually sit down on my desk in winters and the other end is always too cold to be on the desk, so I love when tablets have keys in them. But these are special because they're mechanical, and I'll talk about them later in the video. Thanks to Veikk for sending me their new tablet, it was a gift, but they did not pay me to say anything good about it. This is just my honest opinion. So let's get started. This pen tablet has a 10 by 6 inches working area. I find it a very nice size, not too big, not too small. It's a good size if you have, let's say, a 13 inches laptop and you want something that's still portable, but it's also good to keep on a desk in a studio space. This pen tablet is not wireless, so in the box you're gonna find a cable to connect it to your device. If you want to connect it to your Android phone, because it's compatible with Android, you need to buy an adapter separately. The pen is battery-free, lightweight and ergonomic. I find it comfortable to hold. It also comes in a little felt case. You also get spare nibs with the nib remover and extra keycaps to customize the mechanical keys on the tablet. And that's it, this tablet is around $50. You're getting the basics, and for the price, it's perfect. You get all that you really need and no frills. This tablet also has a dial on it. Dials are just so quick and convenient to use to change things like the brush size, to zoom in and out, to rotate the canvas. So I love that this tablet has one. Now to the keys. They are mechanical, as I said, and I love that so much. I love keys that have a clear sound to them so that I know when I click them. I find them extremely satisfying to use and also really comfortable, because with mechanical keys, I don't really have to press hard for them to work. Now about the switches. I don't know much about them, but I know that these are low profile and they have this double mount that's very uncommon to see in mechanical keyboards. I guess they went for a very flat design, so they chose this. And it's nice that they added spare keycaps in the box so that you can play around with them. The surface of the tablet has a matte finish, and I find that it gives just the right amount of friction, so it's very nice to draw on it. It's not slippery or overly textured, just perfect, I think. For the tablet to work on your computer, you need to download and install the driver. It's quite easy to do, you just need to go on the website and do as I'm showing you right now. Unfortunately, the driver is nothing special, it's not compatible with other brands' drivers, so for this tablet to work, for the driver to work properly, you need to remove all the other tablets' drivers, if you have any. Of course, if you don't have any, skip the step, you don't have to. But for instance, if you have a tablet from another brand, let's say you have a display tablet and you bought this as a second device for portability or for your posture, you can't use them at the same time, because if your display tablet is from another brand, the drivers are not going to be compatible. So what's going to happen is that if you want to switch device, you have to constantly install and uninstall the drivers of your tablets, and it's going to be messy and uncomfortable. So if you're buying this as your lonely tablet, definitely recommend it, no problems. If you have tablets from other brands and you still want to use them, unfortunately, I cannot recommend this to you, because of the driver's issue. If you have another device from Veikk, I think it's also gonna work well. I don't think they're incompatible with their own tablets. So yeah, these are things you have to think about if you wanna buy this. But I know that they're constantly working on their drivers, updating them and stuff like that. So I hope that we'll solve these issues very soon. Other than that, everything works well. I quite like how sensitive the pen is to pressure. You can make a mark even with the slightest touch, just like a pen would on paper. And that's really important for people that tend to be light-handed. Of course, it also depends on the brush you use, and everything is adjustable to your liking in the driver. The important thing is that it works with light-handed people, because heavy-handed people have it easy. Also, the tilt works so well, I was so impressed. Every time I use this tablet, I use brushes that have tilt because it just works very well. I like it so much. I've been testing this tablet for around 2 weeks. There weren't many problems. They had a problem with the customization of the dial, but they fixed it. And yeah, everything else works perfectly. And a nice thing is the possibility to use this tablet even with your phone. The thing is, you need to buy an adapter separately. So thank God I had one, so I was nice to try it to see how it works. And it works really well. I didn't think it was gonna work because I have a pretty old phone. I bought it like 5 years ago. But it works perfectly. I was so impressed. It's a bit weird to draw on it because the phone screen is smaller than the working area of the tablet, so it takes some getting used to, but it's so nice you can do that. As usual, is there an illustration I made using this pen tablet? I use clips to paint, as you can see. I like using clips to paint, but I've been using it less and less recently, so I kind of forgot how to use it. I'm rediscovering my love for digital art lately, but I'm having problems with painting contrast, which is a mistake a lot of beginners make, and I'm making it myself again. It's just like learning all over again. Biggest mistake beginners make with digital art is blending too much and the lack of contrast, and I'm making just that mistake and I need to fix it. I need to practice more, paint more and more to improve. I just don't know, like every shadow I draw seems so dark and I ended up erasing it and making it way too light, and at the end I just think that it should be darker, but then when I make it darker it looks weird to me somehow. So yeah, it's a mess. I just need to improve and practice more, yeah. So far, I'm pleased with this pen tablet. It works well. I'm probably gonna use it for a while because I'm too lazy to install all the other drivers again on my computer. That's it for this video. Yeah, thank you so much for watching and bye-bye. See you.